Oh, very pleasant morning to all my dear little children. Welcome back to English Online Class of Sri Gokulam Public School, Guruvayur. How are you all doing, children? I hope you all are doing great and staying safe at home. Yes? Okay, children, then let's start our today's session. Today, let's do something that will improve our writing skills. Let's discuss diary writing. So, today we'll discuss diary writing. We'll see what is the purpose of diary writing and what is the format of diary writing. You all might be familiar with the topic diary writing and you might be writing diary regularly. Still, let's recollect what we know about diary writing. The very first thing that comes to our mind when we hear about diary writing is one of the best known books in the world, is one of the famous books, and that is A Diary of a Young Girl, written by Anne Frank. Anne Frank is the writer of this famous book. Anne Frank and her family, they were confined to a hiding place. They were forced to stay in a hiding camp during the World War II, during the time of World War II. And she had nothing else to do in the hiding camp. What will they do in the hiding camp? Even we were confined to our homes during the initial stages of novel coronavirus, isn't it? And what did we do? We tried to find the treasure within us. What is that treasure? Our talents. We realized our talents and we started to develop our talents. Some were interested in cooking, some were interested in painting, some were interested in bottle art, and our activities go on. We were engaged in some or other activities. We utilized those period creatively, isn't it? So Anne Frank also utilized her days in the hiding camp creatively. She was passionate about writing. So she thought that she would start to write a diary. That's how she started to write a diary. And almost 2 years they spent in that hiding place, in that hiding camp. After 2 years they were caught and she died at a very young age due to some illness, due to some sickness. Okay, and she died. It is after her death, her father found her diary and he published. It was her dream to write books, and even if it was after her death, her father, he tried to make her dream come true. He published this book and this book became very famous. So she is known as a German diarist. Anne Frank is from Germany and she is known as, or now she is known as a German diarist. So children, what is diary writing, or otherwise it's also known as diary entry? Diary entry or diary writing is a personal document to record or to store one's feelings, emotions or thoughts on a daily basis. It's an account or record of daily happenings. We can record whatever events we had or whatever experience we had on that particular day. So diary entry or diary writing is a personal record of one's feelings following the events, either sad or pleasant. We can record any of our experience. Let it be a happy experience, let it be a sad experience, our joys, our sorrows, our fears. All those we can record in a diary. Anne Frank, she used to write diary in order to express her fears, her hopes or her struggles while they were in the camp. So in order to avoid that boredom, she used to write diary. So we can also start writing diary in order to express our feelings. It's a great source of expression of our feelings. So you all can start writing diaries. It would be your best friend. You can consider your diary as your best friend because you can share your intimate feelings or thoughts to your diary. It should be very informal. You don't have to use formal language. You don't have to be very serious when you write diary. Use informal language. Make it short. Let it be a summary of the events that happened on that particular day. Children, what is the purpose of why do we write a diary? We write a diary in order to record our personal feelings, our emotions or thoughts on a daily basis. To record the daily happenings in our life. Okay? Though diary writing has no set rules and regulations, some features are to be followed. We have to follow some features. There is no strict rules or regulations as a format of diary writing. Still, there are some features that are to be followed. Let's see those features. Let's see the format of diary writing. First and foremost, you have to mention the day. Then you have to mention the date. You also have to mention the time of writing the diary. These three things are very essential It's very important when you write a diary. First, you have to write the day. Suppose you are going to start writing a diary today, you can mention Tuesday. Then in the next line, you can mention today's date, 22nd December. You can write in words. Then at the right side or at the right top of the corner, you can write the time at which you are writing the diary. And I told you that we used to write diary at night. Suppose you will sleep at 10, you can write the diary at 9 p.m. Okay, so mention the date, then date, then at the right side you can mention the time. Day and date should be mentioned near the margin on the left side, and it should be on the topmost part of your diary. Okay, then you can give the salutation. How will you give the salutation? You can imagine any name. You can give any imaginary name to your diary. Our Anne Frank, she used Kitty. She used to address her diary as Kitty, dear Kitty. That's how she used to write her diary. That's how she used to give the salutation in her diary. So we can also use any imaginary names. For example, dear Sweetie, any names that you like. After the salutation, you can narrate the event or the experience you had on that particular day. Suppose you had happy experience, or suppose you had sad experience, you can narrate all those or describe those events in your diary. So first give an introduction, then you can narrate the events, and in the final, in the last sentence, you can give a concluding remark. The last sentence that makes a conclusion of the diary. So when you write the diary, you have to use the first person, that is I or we. You have to use I or we, the pronouns I or we, when you write the diary. And all the sentences should be in the past tense, because you are recording the events or you are writing the events that already happened, about a completed action. You are writing or you are narrating the events that is already over. Okay, so you have to write in past tense. So when you narrate the event or when you narrate the experiences you had, in the first line you can give an introduction. I had an exciting day today. I had a depressing day today. You can start like that. Then you can start narrating the events. And when you narrate the events, it should be in a chronological order. It should be in a proper order. The first event should be written first. Then you can narrate all those actions that happened on that particular day. So first you can say, today was an exciting day for me. Or I had a thrilling experience today. So you can use had or was in order to show the past form of the verbs, okay, in order to show that actions already completed. So use past tense. Then you can narrate the events one by one. You have to write in an order, okay. And at last you can give a concluding remark. How will you conclude your diary? So suppose you became the top scorer, and how will you end? As concluding remark or as the last sentence, you can write, I will keep up my studies. I keep on studying. I will maintain good scores in my life. You can conclude in such a manner. Then you can write bye for now and write your name. This bye for now is not compulsory, but still you can write bye for now and your name. As you consider diary as your best friend, you can write in such a manner. I hope you understood how to write a diary. There is no strict format or strict rules, but still there are some features, and I hope you understood those features. You had to mention the day, you had to mention the date, and you had to mention the time. Then you had to give the salutation. Then you can narrate the event, and you can write at the last bye for now and your name. So this is how you write the diary. I hope you all understood. So copy down the notes that are attached. I have given you 4 samples, so you can copy the same in your grammar textbook. So I'll keep the notes open for 2 days, that is on Tuesday and Wednesday. So you can write 2 diaries on a day, and you can complete the notes by Wednesday. Children, I also hope that you started working on your project, your art integrated project. So our topic is create a poster or make a poster on endangered species, both in Himachal Pradesh and Kerala. You don't have to compare both the 2 states. Instead, you can list some of the endangered species. It can be a species of plants, it can be species of animals or birds. Okay, so you can mention the species of plants, animals or birds that are getting extinct whose number is getting reduced. Okay, so you can give the list of such birds, animals or plants. You can just mention 4 or 5 species of plants, animals or birds. Not all the species, any of 4 species. Okay, any of 4 species you can mention in a A4 sheet. Okay, you have to make a poster. You all know how to make a poster. So you have to give a social message through your poster. For example, if it is to save environment, you can say plant more trees to save future generation. We used to say in such a manner, isn't it? Yes. To give a social message. So you are creating a poster to give a social message to protect these endangered species. So I hope you will write your messages in a catchy titles, isn't it? Yes. So you have to draw those pictures, okay children? Try to draw. Don't stick the pictures of animals, birds or plants. Children, you draw it by yourself so you can develop your talents. Okay. So don't try to stick the pictures. Try to draw it by yourself. I hope you will start working on the project as soon as possible. You have to submit your project on or before 28th by 2 p.m. So you all have to complete the project as soon as possible. Children, I also wish you a very happy Christmas in advance. As this is our last English class before the Christmas, I also wish you a very happy Christmas in advance. So children, it's time to conclude our session here. That's all for today. See you in the next class.